Welcome to Engineering Chemistry class. Let me introduce myself. I am Dr. J. Saranya, working as an Associate Professor in Chemistry, Department of Humanities and Science, Gokaraja Rangaraju Institute of Engineering and Technology. I am handling Engineering Chemistry for first year B.Tech Engineering students. Now, I am going to explain the course objectives, course outcomes of Engineering Chemistry, and I am going to teach you some introduction part in unit 1. Guys, before beginning the class, let me give few instructions. Firstly, I recommend you all to listen to my class properly, because I will post the quiz questions. You will need to attend the quizzes, which will be helpful to this learning process effectively. Secondly, I recommend you all to take paper and pen, because you will be having reflections part in the middle of this video or in my course. The objective of engineering chemistry is to develop the interest among the students regarding chemistry and their applications in engineering. We, the faculty of chemistry, designed 5 course objectives based on the syllabus of engineering chemistry. First objective is to relate how the basic concepts and the principles of chemistry can be applied to practical utility in a broader perspective of the society, and to distinguish the ranges of electromagnetic spectrum and its interaction with the matter, and to develop knowledge of various spectroscopic techniques at atomic and molecular levels, and to identify and apply various principles of electrochemistry, corrosion and water treatment, which are essential for an engineer in industry. To acquire knowledge of existence of different organic molecules in different stereochemical orientations useful for understanding reaction pathways. Finally, to bring adaptability to the concepts of chemistry and to acquire the required skills to become a perfect engineer. The course outcomes of engineering chemistry are, dear students, at the end of this engineering chemistry course, you'll be able to analyze microscopic chemistry in terms of atomic and molecular orbitals and also intermolecular forces. And you'll be able to relate electromagnetic spectra used for exciting different molecular energy levels in various spectroscopic techniques and their application in medicine and other fields. You'll be able to understand the fundamental principles of electrochemistry for energy production and corrosion prevention. You'll be able to recognize various problems related to corrosion in industry and is able to explain different prevention techniques. You'll be able to know the origin of different types of engineering materials used in modern technology and interpret the different problems involved in industrial utilization of water. Unit 1, atomic and molecular structure. In this unit, we have 8 lessons. First lesson is atomic and molecular orbitals. Second lesson is LCAO and MOT. Third lesson, molecular orbitals of homonuclear diatomic molecules like nitrogen and oxygen. Fourth lesson is metallic bonding. Fifth lesson is valence bond theory. Sixth lesson is postulates of crystal field theory. Seventh lesson is crystal field splitting in octahedral complexes. And last lesson is the crystal field splitting in tetrahedral and square planar complexes. Let us move on to the first unit. First lesson, atomic and molecular orbitals. Guys, as I told in the beginning of this class, take paper and pen, pause this video for a while, write the answers on a paper, then resume and finally check whether your answers are correct or wrong. Write the definition of orbit and orbital. Yes, guys, you have written right. Orbit is a fixed path along which electrons revolve around the nucleus of the atom. What is atomic orbital? It is a three-dimensional region around the nucleus where the probability of finding an electron is maximum. And what is molecular orbital? A region around the nuclei of the bonded atoms in a molecule where the probability of finding an electron is maximum. And what is quantum number? See, in quantum mechanics, three quantum numbers are required to describe the distribution of electrons in atoms. These numbers are derived from mathematical solution of Schrodinger wave equation for the hydrogen atom. They are principal, magnetic and angular quantum numbers. These quantum numbers will be used to describe atomic orbitals and used to label the electrons. A fourth quantum number, that is spin quantum number, which describes the behavior of a specific electron. This is the Schrodinger wave equation. This equation forms the basis for the modern quantum mechanical model of an atom. Electrons may be considered either as particle or of wave nature. Therefore, an electron in an atom may be described as occupying an atomic orbital or by wave function psi, which are solution to the Schrodinger wave equation. So wave function psi is a mathematical function related to probability of finding the particle in a particular region or space. The equation 1 describes the Cartesian form of Schrodinger wave equation, where E is equal to total energy, V is potential energy, H is Planck's constant, and psi is wave function. This theory explains the dynamic properties of microscopic particles in motion with high speeds in terms of wave nature of particles. This Cartesian coordinate form of a Schrodinger wave equation can be transformed into spherical coordinates. Spherical coordinates, we will get the second equation. So the solutions of Schrodinger wave equation obtained in terms of expression for r, theta, psi are acceptable only if they follow the restrictions of quantum numbers n, l and m. Principal quantum number is represented as n, and it is the value is 1, 2, 3 and so on. And angular quantum number or azimuthal quantum number is represented as L, that is n minus 1, 0, 1, 2, etc. and so on. Magnetic quantum number M is equal to minus L to plus L, that is 0, 1, 2, etc. up to n plus or minus 1 or n plus or minus 2. So depending on the values of L, the orbitals or electrons are given. For s orbital, L equal to 0, and if L equal to 1, it represents p orbital. L equal to 2 means d orbital. L equal to 3 means f orbital. And shapes of orbital. We know s orbital is spherical in shape, p orbital is dumbbell shape, and it has three orbitals, pxy, pyz, px, py and pz. D orbitals have phi shapes, double dumbbell. So the shape of the orbital can be formed from the probabilities at different points around the nucleus, which are obtained by finding the values of wave function in terms of psi, r, theta, psi. For s orbital, L value and m value is 0. For p orbital, L value is 1. So we will get m value plus minus 1, 0 and plus 1. It represents Px, Py and Pz. And d orbital, L equal to 2, m equal to minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2. And coming to the comparison between atomic and molecular orbitals, atomic orbital belong to only one specific atom and they are the internal characteristics of an atom. Whereas molecular orbital belong to all atoms in a molecule and they result when atomic orbitals of similar energies combine together. Atomic orbitals have simple shapes of geometry and are named as s, p, d, f, etc. Whereas molecular orbitals have complex shapes and are designated as sigma, phi, delta, etc. The stability of atomic orbitals are less than the bonding and more than the antibonding orbitals. Whereas the stability of molecular orbitals are either more or less than the atomic orbitals. Atomic orbitals are monocentric, whereas molecular orbitals are polycentric. So coming to the summary, we saw what is an atomic orbital, what is a molecular orbital, and solutions of wave equation, Schrodinger wave equation. So Schrodinger wave equation is used to locate the address of an electron. And finally, we saw the four orbitals and the shape of the orbitals. I hope you understand this topic. Let us meet in this lesson 2. Thank you, students.